Hi! Welcome to Christina Land, a place for grown-up gift givers and adult toy collectors. Today, I'm going to unbox Ariel from the Disney store, as well as her accessory pack, also from the Disney store. Now, you will notice that this is not the new packaging. This is the old packaging. So, right now, the new packaging, which is environment friendly, is $19.99. However, this was the older version. List price was $16.99, but I got her at my Disney store when it went bye-bye, which means it was 25% off. And 25% off of $16.99 is like $3.50 off, $4 off. And then this I bought online at the Disney store because it was not at my Disney store before it went bye-bye, so I could not get it, so I got it online. And I'm really curious to see how this fits the Ariel doll because I've seen people review it online at the Disney store saying it doesn't fit. So I'm quite curious. I also wanted to do this review now because if you're like me, and the Disney store is not in your area, you will need to get this sooner than later, especially if you are planning this as a Hanukkah gift, as Hanukkah is coming up soon, or if you want this as a Christmas gift, and shipping is taking a while, but it used to. I believe you can pay to get expedited shipping. I don't remember how much it is, but I know it's more, and I usually don't do expedited shipping. The one time, and this wasn't Disney store, but the one time I did expedited shipping, it did not come in time. So that's why I will never do it again. And if things don't come in time, that is what it is. All right, let's open the Ariel Princess doll. And I'm pretty sure she's exactly the same as the new one, just the new one is in environment-friendly packaging, which means she doesn't have gel in her hair, which I'm sad kind of that this one will have a ton of gel in her hair because I would really like an Ariel with soft hair, but that's okay because I got her cheaper. And I was able to pick out the Ariel I liked best since I was actually at the Disney store, which went bye-bye. Very depressing. Okay, scissors. I have a feeling she's going to take a while to open, so it's also why when I get the environmental friendly doll, it'll be so exciting because it has the cardboard box packaging and it's like a scene and it's really easy to open, and this is definitely not easy to open. I don't even know how to start. Start somewhere. I'm just bracing myself to open. Just really opening things. Opening Disney store things can just take a while. Okay, let's put the scissors down before I hurt myself. Good call, good call. I'm just gonna, you know. Oh man, there is a lot of things to undo on the back, like a lot of things. Yuck. Haha, look at that. Okay, no, she isn't free yet, but I did the front of her, so that's exciting. Yay! I have not had an Ariel doll before, or at least not 11 and a half inch size Ariel doll. So I have a small animator's Ariel doll, but not this one. And yes, I don't like how she's sparkly everywhere. Like her purple top is sparkly, her mermaid tail is sparkly, so don't like the feel of that sparkly material. My fingers are not a fan. Okay. And yeah, her hair is incredibly gelled, very, very stiff. You would have to wash it if you want to brush it because it is, yeah, stiff all over. I feel like this won't take too long for me to open, so I'm going to do it on camera, and we'll find out. I mean, it probably will now that I said that it won't, because that makes sense. I mean, there's not like a ton of tabs, but the scissors fail. I'm putting them down. Okay, I know it's better to do it from the back, but I'm not going to. It's probably much better to undo this from the back and safer. But again, I'm not going to because I feel like it will take too long to do. Just being very careful. Very careful. Let's see, did that help? No. Carefully cutting, good, good. Cutting you, good. And you, great. Oh, there's a thing up here. And more things up here. Okay, wow. And then things down here. She's probably gonna fall out as I do this. I have a feeling she's going to, but maybe, nope, stop it. Maybe she won't. What do you think? Whoop! Ha! Okay. Good, good. Okay. Okay, she's able to break free. Oh, we're so close. We're so close. So, her tail is like, oh, I see it. Okay, to cut from the front side with her tail. Very careful, very careful. And now there's this thing. I think I have to, oh wait, no I don't. That thing contains the little clip-on character pendant for me. Well, yep. How I do things. I'm cutting very carefully. I know it's probably better to cut in the back, but like the back is all filled with tape, so we're so close, Ariel. Okay, and cut this red part out, which. She's free! Yay! Lots of plasticky stuff. Lots of plasticky, lots of plastic stuff. Oh, I don't like the feel of her tail. Nope, 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 nope. Yes, so her hair is very, very stiff. Do not like the feel of her tail at all. Blech. This feel is, no, my hands don't care for it. I mean, I like that her hair is in this nice wave. It's fun. I mentioned I don't like her tail. I don't like the feel of her tail. No, we don't like that. It just, I don't know. My hands don't care for it. But she has a green mermaid tail that can come off. And it's, I don't like the feel of it, in case you couldn't tell. It has glittery green scales on it, and then her mermaid tail is like a mesh, light green mesh material. She has a green sparkly top that represent her seashells. She has blue eyes. I think she looks very much like Ariel from the movie. And she can move at the wrists, at the elbow, at the shoulders. Oh, I didn't like the, ugh, did not like the feel of that. She can move her head back and forth. And a little bit up and down. Cool. Okay. And probably you don't have sensitive fingers like I do, so you won't mind the tail, but I just don't like it. So I'm really glad that I got this so I can change her into it. And I am going to show the changing process, so there will be doll nudity. Some people really mind that. I'm not sure why, because it's a doll. But I'm just throwing it out there. Alright, I feel like this won't take as much time to open, but I'm probably wrong. You know, I'm just ripping it. That's what I do. Just rip things. So this outfit of Ariel's is meant to represent her market day dress when she goes out on the town with Eric. It doesn't look quite like it. So, like, it's light blue puff sleeves with a light blue ribbon, a printed on dark blue corset. Is it corset or corset? I think it's corset. But when I first read the word, I always envisioned it as corset. I'm pretty sure it's corset. Can you let me know in the comments? Corset. That's the first way, or corset, the second way. I think it's corset, though. So let me know if it is the first way. I think it is. And then a light blue skirt with printed on details of a ship, star, waves from the ocean, fish. And before I go to the rest, let's just take it out. Carefully, though. Carefully. And I think this time we're going to cut it from the back because I don't want to cut the material. I find it's easier to cut, for me, from the front of dolls because usually the plastic ties that tie them together, they're like looser around the doll, so you know you're not going to accidentally cut the doll. But clothes, the ties are really close to the clothes, so I don't want to cut the clothes. I don't know where that one went. They're just, you know, well, that one went way over there. Yep. That one went over there. That's fun. Oh, maybe I should take out that pendant over there. Okay, let's take out the pendant. It is in here. Yep. In here. And it is, okay, is it this way? Oh, it is this way. There you go. A plastic pendant that came with the doll, and it no longer does because this was the old packaging. So it's a silhouette of Ariel's head. Her head's in like a black gray material. And then the outline around her is a light blue, and then it's encased in this plastic silver pendant. That's for me. I don't know where to put it though. I guess I'll put it right there. Hello. Goodbye. Okay. So there's tape on the back of here. I'm gonna crumple that tape up, put it over there. See, the problem is when they do tape on the back of here, like, it's hard for me to undo the tape. It probably shouldn't be, but it is. That's, oh, hey, look at that. I'm undoing it. I'm kind of undoing it. I'm not undoing it at all. Well, thought about it. I'm gonna take this little tag off. Plastic tag off. Okay. Ah, yay! I did it. It's not. Do you know if there's tape on cardboard, is that okay to put in recycling? I think it is. I'm gonna check because I think it is, but then I'm not sure. So I usually take the tape off, but that can be a very tedious time. I will look into that and let you know right here if tape can go on cardboard when putting in recycling, because that's important to know. Okay. So like I said, it is one-piece dress. It is light blue puff sleeves. It's like a satiny, plasticky material. And a little light blue bow. And a printed-on dark blue corset. And a medium blue dress part that has white outlines of the ship. Starfish, probably, of waves, of fish. And the back of the dress also has, come on camera, you're doing so well. You can do it. Don't focus on my background. It's a fun background. There we go. And the outline of the dress goes the back of the dress as well. There's outline of seagulls. Also has some nice lace, white lace, at the edge of the dress, the bottom of the dress. Also comes with this jacket. This dark blue jacket, which is okay, it is cheap material. And it does have several holes in it because it came with plastic things. I don't know if you can see the holes because it came, oh yeah, so see, that's one of the holes. A dark blue jacket with printed gold buttons and a printed light blue outline. Look, and more holes. I don't know if you could see this one. From the plastic thing is being in it. And she... Ha! That was fun. Good thing my mouth was closed. Could have gone in my mouth. I could have swallowed it. I'd have to go to the hospital like kids go to when they swallow things. But yeah, that didn't happen. It comes... So yeah, be careful when you're opening this up. Have your mouth closed because it'll just pop into you. It'll get you. So it is a blue plastic ribbon barrette. I would have liked it if it were a real ribbon, because I don't know how I can get this in Ariel's hair, but we're going to find out. Alright, this time I'm going to pop it on my platform so it doesn't get me. Whew, safe. Two blue plastic flat shoes. And a plastic basket with a sandwich, like a big loaf of bread with like lettuce, like plastic lettuce, plastic, I don't know, all kinds of plastic things in there, different colors things, like tomatoes, meat, who knows, but it's definitely bread with stuff in it, but it's all made of plastic and it's in this plastic basket, so it's together, you can't take it out, but the plastic, what is this called? The basket work, like it has textured basket work, like it goes all around the basket, so that's cool. They didn't have to do that. They sometimes don't do that, so that's cool. Okay, let's see how hard it is to take off Ariel's outfit and put on this outfit. I don't know. It'll be interesting. Oh, I hate that. I know, I said it. I don't need to keep harping on it. I just dislike the material on my mermaid tail. Okay, come on, tail, we can get off. It's okay, you can do it. She has green underwear, that's cool. Green painted on underwear. Ha! Looks like, little bit of green glitter. Oops. Sorry, outfit. I'm following you. Not following you. I'm dropping you. Yeah. A little bit of green glitter on her thighs, but I don't think there's really dye transfer. It's just the glitter from her tail. But now she feels so much better. Oh, look at this. She has non-flat feet. Which are high-heeled feet, is that what we call it? Arched feet? I really, whoops, nope, that's okay, it's a tail I don't like. I really thought that the Disney store had done, like all their dolls have flat feet now, and, oh bother, oh there they are. And these shoes are flat, so can they go on high-heeled dolls? Oh, is that what we're calling it? Maybe it's high-heeled feet. Because, like I know, a video I watched a while ago from Beauty Inside a Box, I'll put a link to his YouTube channel in my description. He talks about, I won't put a link to his exact description because I don't know where this was, but like he has great videos. But he talks about how Disney dolls no longer have high-heeled feet. And I didn't realize this because I usually buy Rapunzel because I am obsessed with Rapunzel. And she should have flat feet because she doesn't wear shoes, so I never thought about, huh. But like for Cinderella, Cinderella should have high-heeled feet because her glass slippers should be high-heeled. But I've seen other unboxings of the Disney dolls where they have flat feet, but Ariel has the high-heeled feet. Do you know if this is also the case for the new Ariel in her cardboard boxing? Can you let me know in the comments? Because I'm really curious about that. I'm also curious to know if these shoes will fit her since she has high-heeled feet. Huh, this is so fascinating. Look at that. She has a bend and snap legs. She has high-heeled feet. I'm fascinated. Okay, we're going to take off her top. So, nudity, doll nudity, coming at ya. And I'm going to try to take off her top. Well, I guess you just see in the back, because... So, it's just the back of her. Now, we are going to... put on this dress. So this outfit came at the same time as they released this newer doll, so the assumption is that it should fit this newer doll. I mean, she's not newest because she's not the one with the happy plastic-free boxing. Here in this chair, and I wonder if these hands come off. Do you think they do? It'd be nice if they did, because then I could, like... But what if they don't, you know? What if they don't? I'm gonna try to take hands off, just because other dolls you can take their hands off, so I don't want to assume. Not that I can take the other hands dolls up, but the other dolls I tried in a previous video. It didn't work. You know what? Nope. I'm scared too. I'm scared too because I don't want to hurt you. Okay. We are going to figure this out. Yes. Because there's a way to do this, obviously. It's a special secret way. Now, if her hands could come off, that'd be great, because that would make it so much easier. But again, I don't know. I don't know. I don't want to try. Okay, I got one hand in. Nope, just kidding. I almost got one hand in. It was very close. Very close. The thumb is just out there. The thumb is like, does not want to cooperate, which I feel is rude. You should cooperate, thumb, you know? Okay, got that one on. Now we're going to do this one. She's so pretty. Looks just like Ariel. Yay. Okay. Oh, she does have a little... Oh, that was glitter. Thought she had a paint defect, but it was glitter. Okay. I know, this isn't very exciting. You're watching... I'm not gonna put her in the front because, like, I wouldn't be able to see what I'm doing. Like, I could try to tell in the camera, but it wouldn't work very well, so we're just not gonna do that. Okay. I have three of her fingers in. No, I don't. I did have three of her fingers in, but then they went away. Just... Okay. You know, I was trying to put it there so it'd be more interesting for you instead of just seeing me struggle and you can't see anything, but... Well, at least you can feel the struggle. Okay, I have three fingers in her sleeve. Four fingers. Do you know? I probably already asked this, but do you know if these hands come off? Because that'd be great if they did, but... Oh! I did it! Yay! Okay, we can do it. Maybe. Her sleeve is stuck on... Oh, there we go. Was stuck on her joint. Okay, yay. Whoops. Okay, so there, I mean, this is only $9.99, but there are some loose threads you can see on her sleeves. Again, I got this online because I didn't see it in the Disney in my Disney store when it when I went to Buy Buy. So there are loose sleeves. I think she looks pretty in it. Yeah. Okay, let's see if the shoes fit on our high heel shoes, because these are flat, so I don't know if they would work. So this looks like the left shoe. Oh, hello. Yes, this is the left shoe. I guess it works. That's exciting, because I have a Tiana outfit that I bought to fit a very old Tiana doll I have. Like, it, I think my Tiana doll is from 2011 or 2012, so it's a very old Tiana doll. And I bought the new accessory pack for her because, I mean, Tiana wears the most gorgeous clothes. Come on, they should make all the clothes for Tiana. Let me know in the comments if you agree, because seriously, Tiana's fashion sense, amazing. Even though she's a frog for a lot of the movie, she has the most outfit changers. Like, seriously, from all the princesses, they need to make a ton of clothes for her. Disney, not that you're watching my channel at all, but please, please, give Tiana a bunch of clothes. You can do it. Gorgeous clothes. Okay, that's all. Anyway, my point is that I'm excited that these flat shoes seem to work. Her high-heeled feet, because my Tiana definitely has high-heeled feet, and the shoes that comes in the accessory pack are flat, so that's exciting. All right, I'm gonna attempt to put this bow in her hair. I have no idea where. I mean, I really don't think it'll work, honestly. I mean, I guess I'll just put it in the back and like, it won't really like, just be there for fun. So that's what I did. Like, it obviously doesn't like do anything. Maybe I should try. See if I can actually, whoops, just getting stuck in the hair, definitely stuck in the hair, and then you fall, just fine, because now you're not stuck in the hair. Let's see, it's just, she's very gelled. Okay, here's a patch where she's not gelled. Meh. I mean, probably the bow shoe the other way, now I think about it. Okay. The plastic hair bow came undone. Yeah, I mean, it's okay. Now let's see if the jacket can go on. I feel like this jacket might not go on because of her poofy sleeves. Let us find out. Yeah. As we drop the jacket. And it's a chore to put it over her hands. Because there are threads that are loose. Oh no, I had it and then I didn't have it. And I'm singing about it. Because that's what I do. We can do this. We cannot do this. Because there are threads that are in your sleeve. And they get caught in your hand. Oh yeah, I got one of the sleeves on. Because this one doesn't have any threads. So I was able to get it on. This side has like threads stuck in the sleeve, so it's hard to get her arm in it. And now that I have this side on though, I have no idea how to put her arm in this way. So we are just gonna bend it like this. Hope I don't break her. Okay, we're just gonna have to snip this thread because it's just, it's not working. nope, I got you in. You do not do that. Oh. I was gonna say, through all that process, her shoes didn't come off, but one of them did come off. That is okay. Ha! I did it. Yay. Oh. Okay, I will say that because they made the puff sleeves, it is hard to get her jacket on. And also, I mean, let's be honest, the quality of these accessory packs are not very good. They're just not. But again, they're only $9.99. So I think it's fine that they're not good. They're not like the best quality. It is annoying that there's so many loose threads on here. But here is how she looks in her market day outfit. I think it's fine. Okay, yes, it did take a while to get on. But I think she looks really cute in it. Let's do it from here. She can hold the basket. She can hold, there we go, hold the basket. Yeah, obviously it's not the exact dress she wears for the market day, that has a lot more detail, but this is a really good, this is a really good alternative if you want that blue dress, which I have because I've wanted it for a while because I think it's so pretty. So I think this is a great alternative. I like the fact that even though she has high-heeled shoes, the flat blue shoes can work on her because, again, I have Tiana, so it'll be great to put her in her outfit. Let me know in the comments if you want me to open up Tiana's outfit and put it on my 2011 or 2012 doll. Because I haven't changed her clothes for a long time. Yeah, I'm fine with this. It did, oops, that's okay, she didn't want that lunch anyway. It did take a while to put this on, but even though this is like a, I don't know, plasticky, satiny feel, it's obviously not really satin, it kind of feels plasticky a bit. My fingers like the touch of this much better than her mermaid tail, and I really like having her blue dress on. Yeah, so I say if you are a fan of Ariel, or your kid is, or someone else you know, get Ariel, who will be $19.99 because she comes in the plastic-free packaging, and she will have soft hair, which will be really nice. So the back of her hair right here is nice and soft, but then all the other parts are very gelled, very gelled. And that's okay, because that is what it is. That's okay. They also have other accessory packs. Tiana right now is not available. Hers goes really quickly, so if you ever do see Tiana's accessory pack on the Disney store, buy it immediately, because it will go. It will go. Rapunzel's, I believe, just came back in stock. I think there's a Cinderella one. I believe a Pocahontas one. Those are the ones I know, but just search classic doll in the search function on the DisneyStore.com, and it will bring up all the classic dolls and the accessory packs that come with it. Yeah, I like it though. I think it's fine for $10. Like, yeah, I think it's fine to have a dress that looks, you know, like the one she wore in the movie. Not the exact one, no, but it's nice to have different accessory packs with your princess dolls. Especially if you're like me and don't like the glittery feel of the tail. Thank you so much for watching this video. And remember, it's okay to like what you like, be who you are, and stay young at heart. And please like this video and subscribe for more videos. And we will now say goodbye. That's not how Ariel sounds.
I can't do Ariel's voice. Only Jodie Benson can do Ariel's voice, really. Or at least an animated version. So, I'm excited to see the live-action one that's coming up soon. Yay! Or, soon. Kinda soon. Maybe 20, probably 2022. Yeah, now that I think about it, because we're getting close to end 2021. By the way, where did the year go? 2020 seemed to, like, be forever, and 2021, like, gone in a snap. Weird, right? Yes, it's weird. Nope, I can't do a Jodie Benson voice. Okay, bye!